morning, gang. Thank you for joining me. Well, you had the third earthquake near Lake Chabot in the last month along the Hayward Fault. USGS says it was a magnitude 2.9. At 6:21 Pacific Standard Time, 384 people said they felt this earthquake. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. There's the dam. Yeah, there's always a threat that there could be a large earthquake and the dam collapse. And yeah, flooding everybody out with little to no notice. On the 12th of this month, there was a magnitude 3.2. And on the 6th, there was a magnitude 3.1 near Lake Chabot Road. Here's the felt report. We got Oakland, it was felt, San Jose, and Los Banos, I believe that is. It was felt in Pacifica. I got to give a shout out to some people I know who are often here watching my videos there in Pacifica. Felt in Millbrae and close to San Mateo, it looks like. Over here we have Fremont. One report there. Doesn't give a name of the area there. 28 people across the bay. Doesn't give a name of a location. Oh, Union City. 130 responses from Castro Valley and Dublin. We got 4 from Dublin. That 3.2 you guys had on the 12th, over 1,112 people reported it to USGS. That one was a thrust earthquake. I've talked about thrust earthquakes. The difference between a regular thrust earthquake and a reverse thrust earthquake is the angle of the dip of the fault. Reverse thrust has a steeper dip than what happened here. It's where one side of the fault remains stationary and the other one rises up. I know you get them all the time. Yeah, threes are nothing that you take any notice of, but you should. The Hayward Fault is due for a very large earthquake, and geologists say that this fault zone is actually more dangerous than the San Andreas Fault Zone. Just another reminder that you need to be prepared for a major earthquake. This area that I got drawn out in yellow is susceptible to liquefaction, and we got an interstate that runs through here, meaning that the ground turns to quicksand and things sink during an earthquake. There's lots of government information about what to do to prepare for an earthquake. Know where your shutoff valves are for your water and for your gas. Have supplies for yourself, not just food and water for yourself, but also your pets. A carry bag for your pets in case you have to go to a shelter because of damage to your home. Some of the felt reports on EMSE. This one was 1 kilometer south from where it occurred, said it was a small, quick jolt. Another 4 kilometers away said felt it, wondered if it was in the same spot as the last one we had. Low rumble, and then a small bump. Well, the rumble is the first wave of the earthquake, the P wave. P waves travel about 60% faster than the S wave. That's when the shaking starts. A bump, then a hard roll and a shake, it says. Another one says a bump, roll, and a heavy thud shake. That one was sleeping. Well, it was 6:21 a.m. Many people were probably sleeping. A report from Castro Valley. Mild shaking lasted about 3 seconds. Castro Valley near the Hayward border felt mild shake for about 2 seconds. Actually didn't notice anything. Well, they had to put their comment in. Another one said it was small. Another one from Fairview said it was a quick jolt. Another one says a little jolt and then a larger jolt a couple of seconds later. Brisbane said that it sounded like a door closing outside. Another one, Fairfield. They were at work early, or maybe they worked the night shift, said they were on the second floor at work. Thought they felt something, but It was so mild, I brushed it off as my imagination. So, did you feel this earthquake? Did you feel the other three earthquakes? Are you prepared for a large earthquake? What are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing and for your support. You know who you are. Thank you. Get prepared. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.